The televised portion of this event is made possible by NAFA, a National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors of the Lehigh Valley. When you choose an agent or an advisor, make sure you ask if they are a member of NAFA.
Ceremonies for this great Lehigh County Bicentennial Celebration here at the Agriplex. My name is Don Cunningham. I'm the Lehigh County Executive, and I had the great honor of serving as the chair of our Lehigh County Bicentennial Committee, which was a committee of about 40 people that began working on these events 2 years ago in 2010. And we've been very fortunate to have a cross-section of our community that has helped to plan this event, and a lot of tremendous volunteers who are working here today and corporate sponsors who have stepped forward to make this a free and public ceremony for the people of Lehigh County. I believe we are going to begin our opening ceremony with a great a cappella singing group from the city of Bethlehem, the Bethlehem Rotary Morganaires.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed and the twilight's last gleaming, whose bright stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say,
this young nation of the United States was just formulating and getting ready to head into another battle with Great Britain as we were still finding our way as a young nation. At that same time, the people here in what was then the western part of Northampton County decided that they wanted to have their own county, decided that they wanted to have their own identity. And most of all, the Pennsylvania German farmers didn't want to have to ride their horses for 3 days to get to Easton to go to the courthouse to file their deeds and paperwork. It was that spirit that created on March 6th of 1812, after the culmination of a lot of work, the creation of Lehigh County as it was signed into existence by the then governor of Pennsylvania. 200 years later, a lot has happened here. We have a very proud history and heritage and great individuals who have come from this county and served this country so well in so many capacities. I want to bring to the podium now someone who has been instrumental in making this celebration happen, someone who has been a business leader and a community leader across not only Lehigh County, but across the Lehigh Valley. He is the face of Coca-Cola bottling here in the Lehigh Valley that have been such a generous donor and supporter of community activities and quality of life initiatives in Lehigh County. The name of his company hangs on our great baseball stadium owned by the county where our beloved AAA Philadelphia Phillies Iron Pigs play. And Coca-Cola Bottling Company of the Lehigh Valley is the presenting sponsor of all the events of this Lehigh County Bicentennial that would not be possible without the philanthropy and the commitment of Joe Brake, the president and CEO of Lehigh Valley Bottling Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Joe, would you like to come up here? Let's give him a great round of applause. So,
on behalf of all the employees of the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of the Lehigh Valley, I'd like to just say how thrilled we are to be part of this celebration. Lehigh County means very much to us. We have an ongoing partnership with the county. Right up at Coca-Cola Park is probably one of our greatest ventures that we ever did together. And it's funny, when I was a kid, I grew up in Wilmington, Delaware, and the Phillies had a minor league club there. It was called the Wilmington Blue Rocks. The significance behind that here today is our very own Curt Simmons. That's where he got his major league career start there. And I think that is really cool seeing him being honored here for the Lehigh Valley. And it means something very special for me to be able to see our name on a new park where many more people from the Lehigh Valley will have the opportunity to go into the pros at some point in time and play at that park. So we're very proud of that. We're very thankful for the attendance here this morning, for your support of our company by buying the products. Without that, we can't support the county. So you play a major role in our company, and we all want to say thank you to you very much. And we have a machine out there that talks to you today. So if you wouldn't mind stopping by and talking to the machine and telling the machine what a good machine it is, we'd be really happy about that. So. But thanks again, and congratulations to the county and Don.
We are joined by Drew Chomsky, and we are talking about the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors. And Drew, you are the president of the Lehigh Valley chapter. Did I get that right?
Yes, we are. We are one of over 600 chapters throughout the United States of the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors of Lehigh Valley. And we are here to represent over 74 million families who have insurance and financial products. And we're also here representing the agents and financial representatives to keep a positive legislative and regulatory environment for the agents and for our clients.
So you're like a little safety net for people who don't really know who, what to do or who to work with.
That is exactly right. We are the safety nets for those 74 million families and for our fellow agents and representatives throughout the nation.
Let me ask you this, because as someone who is, might probably is a client somewhere along the way, around the way, or through someone, it's when you go to look for a product that has to do with the things you guys handle, you want to make sure that they're a part of this group, because they're sort of like in that approved group, right? Or
that is true, because they held to the highest ethical standards. They also have the highest training, because we support the local training of the local agency, and that's also support at the national agency. So they're up to date on the current items and training, and it also meets both state and federal laws that it's all coincides. So that's a very important issue. That's why you want to look for a representative that is with the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors.
We're here with Jim Glasick. He is the business development manager for Coca-Cola here in the Lehigh Valley. Jim, we're here looking at a machine like I've never seen before. I know it's a Coke machine, but tell us about what's going on here.
Well, it's the newest and greatest machine for Coca-Cola. It's an interactive vending machine. It's ahead of its time. We have abilities to shoot commercials on this machine. We have a credit card reader that we could utilize. And it's the greatest thing because it's all computerized and technology. We take a little demonstration, pick your flavors, and you can demonstrate by operating and moving the can around, spinning around. You can draw. We can work on our My Coke Rewards. We're going to be able to do everything that you want to do online. You can do it right on the computer. We're going to talk a little bit about the community, do a little bit about what's going on in reference to schedules, events, upcoming events, and back to commercials again. So it's one of the greatest things is it's interactive with the kids. And it's you can get a little bit of an ice covering there, and you can put your hands on there, clear the covering on there, and it'll melt it all down. It's amazing. The kids love it. They come up here, and I guess the only problem we're going to have is to get them away from the machine eventually so they can buy stuff. But other than that, they love it.
We are now joined by the mayor of Allentown, who just happened to be wandering around this great bicentennial celebration. It's amazing, isn't it, Mayor, how many years go by, but look at all the things that are going on.
It is. It's truly amazing. And, you know, this is a great celebration, a great day, celebrating the heritage of Lehigh County. Also, you know, Allentown is celebrating its 250th this year. So this is a year of celebration for not only Allentown, but for Lehigh County and this whole region. There's a lot of great things that have happened here. From the housing of the Liberty Bell to the starting of the Industrial Revolution to, quite honestly, the very first transistor being made here in Allentown. So,
this is what I loved about this. We're meeting all these Hall of Famers that we didn't even know perhaps did all the things they did.
Yeah, and it's just a great event, and my hat's off to the county. They've done a really good job here. And you know, I just want people to know that it's just going to be a year of celebration. We have a lot to celebrate here. We have a great heritage, a great history, not only in this county, but the city. And there's a lot more to come.
Thank you for all your contributions to the city.
Well, thank you. Thank you. And appreciate all you're doing here for the county and helping us commemorate the celebration.
We are now joined by Clay Smith from the Lehigh Valley Community Resource Center. And Clay, thank you for taking time to be with us. I know you do a lot of things. Right now we're talking about the Child ID program. Right. But tell us about children and youth, the resources, everything that's going on, because you have a lot going on.
All right, as you know, our organization, the Lehigh Valley Community Resource Center, we do two primary missions. One is we publish these resource guides that you were just holding for children and youth in the area. Basically, it's a compilation of information of educational development opportunities for families with kids. So we publish those books, and we also do the Child ID event, which we're engaged in here today. We've already ID'd probably about 25 children. It's an electronic process we use where we electronically scan their fingerprints. We do a voice print, a video of the children, and put it all on a CD for mom and dad to take home. It's a great resource or a great tool for emergency responders if a child would ever go missing. Art, again, the main thrust of our mission is really to create awareness for parents of kids of all the opportunities that are available to them. Our books have currently probably about 250 to 300 different organizations, local or regional organizations, that provide services in one of six areas, educationally or developmentally. What we're actually engaged in right now is a pre-launch, if you would, of all this information getting onto the web or onto the internet. That's going to greatly enhance what we have in the directories. The website we're in the midst of building is going to have not only everything we have in our books, but much, much more for families with kids.
So from both the website perspective or the written copy, how do they find a written copy, or can they go online to get that?
Well, they can go on our website, which is real simple. It's LVCRC, for Lehigh Valley Community Resource Center.org. We do have a list of locations up where parents can actually go and pick up copies of the directory if they wish. Very shortly, probably within the next 45 to 60 days, we're going to have they'll be able to go to our website, but they're also going to be able to go through something called Kids Plus Community, which is the name of the site where we're establishing all this information for families.
Now, you have you hit a lot of areas. You're all different counties.
Yeah, we started out here in the last couple of years with Lehigh and Northampton County, but we've actually now expanded into both Bucks County as well as Monroe and Carbon County. Just go to our website, www.lvcrc.org, or kidsandcommunity.org, which will give you immediate access to all the information we've compiled for families with kids.
Take me by my little hand and go like this.
We have been joined by Michelle Vitale, who's part of the Community Service Chair for the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors here in the Lehigh Valley. Michelle, thank you for taking a minute to be with us. I know you're involved in a lot of community things. Maybe you could tell us a little about that.
Well, our programs have been many in the past. We've actually purchased bears for local hospitals to provide comfort for pediatric children. And we've also been involved with Camelot House in the past and hosted their annual Halloween events. We've donated backpacks to foster children that have been helped by Pinebrook Services for children and youth. And we've also collected food, household goods, and furniture for local needy families that we would deliver to them at Christmas time. That particular project was called Operation Santa. Most recently, we're involved with the Lehigh Valley Community Resource Center's Child ID event or program. And this program actually provides a CD to parents with their children's information that can be given to the authorities in the event the children go missing. We actually do photographs for the children, fingerprint them, take voice recordings, and take their height and weight. All that information is fed into a computer, which produces the disc for the parents, and that actual information can be updated as the child matures. So the parent will always have a current photo and current information on that child to give to authorities if necessary. And we've had a very enthusiastic response with that child ID event, and parents have encouraged us to do repeat events at local schools and as well as at events like this bicentennial. And we also want to let everyone know that one of our other current fundraiser events is actually to promote the Beginning Over Foundation, which is for raising awareness for domestic violence abuse victims. So we have a raffle going on, selling tickets, one for $10, three for $20. And if anyone is interested, we'd love them to have a chance to stop by the booth, learn more about that wonderful organization, and they can also contact me at my office if necessary to secure tickets.
You can go online, right?
Yes, absolutely.
We are joined by Andre Reed, who happens to be here today for this great bicentennial event.
Andre, tell us a little about your past, your history. You're part of the history here. You're part of the sports that went on throughout this area.
Right.
And today you're being inducted into the Hall of Fame here.
Yeah, it's a great honor, number one. Number two, just being from this area and to be honored with 24 other people that have gone on to do great things in sports and the military and all that kind of thing. It's just a great honor to be from here and from them, for me to come back here and be a part of it. It's real special, and for my family too, because it's real special for them.
Just mention quickly some of your brief history. You've played in a lot of different events. So tell us about some of the meaningful things that you've done.
Oh, jeez. I don't want to brag, but I'd be here for about 3 days telling you. No, I mean, starting here as a little league football player and then going on to play in the NFL for 16 years, I've been fulfilled many a times. Not only on the sports field, but doing things off the field too. And I think, as athletes, we all tend to look at people. People look at us and see what we do in our profession, but they don't see the little things you do off the field. And I think you're more noticed for that. And I got a lot of help, man, from back here in the valley, and the things that I'm doing, and a lot of people helping me, and for the cause that I'm about. It's real special to me to have all those people behind me.
Let's talk about the cause that's here, because we're standing here in front of some bottles. What's in those? I mean, I'm going to grab one.
Yeah, sure.
Here, you hang on to that. What? Tell us about.
I'm drop it.
Yeah,
no. Right,
what? Tell us what's
this,
in.
This is my own barbecue sauce that I launched about a year ago, called Andre Reed's Over the Middle Sauce, because I went over the middle a lot in my football career. So, that name kind of fits it. And it benefits my foundation, my charitable foundation here. Kids Escaping Drugs, a couple other different foundations I have, organizations with my foundation.
You've got different wristbands, different things.
Yeah, we got a lot of things we're doing here for charity, and we're trying to raise money for kids. And
if they're not here today, how can they still?
They can go onto my website at www.andrereedotm.com. They can buy the sauce there, buy the charity bands, check up on me, see what I'm doing, where I'm at, the next couple events I'll be at, what I'm doing. And it's real fun because it's fulfilling in a way, not only what I did on the field, but it's fulfilling off the field too.
We are here with Matt White Eagle from the Indian Museum of Indian Culture. And Matt, thank you for being here. You're all in garb and everything's authentic. Tell us about what it is you do and where you're located.
Actually, what I do is I'm a Native American performing artist, and I do a lot of Native dancing, the hoop dance, the grass dance. And right now, today, we're here at the fair to demonstrate a lot of ethnic dances and a lot of artifacts that we have. And I perform over at the Indian Museum, the Museum of Indian Culture, here in Fish Hatchery Road in Allentown.
We are joined by Marianne Yasso, and she is also with the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors as treasurer and also
national committee person.
National, and what would that be?
I'm the liaison between the local and the state and the national NAFA.
Well, let's talk about how people can take advantage of the group, because a lot of people are unfamiliar with NAFA, perhaps, or maybe they're not. But if they are unfamiliar, this NAFA group really is there to help a lot of people. How can they take advantage of that?
Well, actually, what NAFA is, it's a voluntary organization, and it's made up of insurance agents, financial service professionals from many different companies throughout the whole Lehigh Valley. So our biggest thread holding us together is we're all committed to our profession. and to commit it to our clients' financial success. I think the biggest thing is we represent 74 million households, and our goal is to protect and promote using insurance in a sound financial plan. Doesn't matter how much you save, Art, if you have a catastrophic event. Our next goal is to make sure our agents are educated, professional, and ethical, and how they can help clients.
You know, it wasn't easy changing all your rock and roll, man. Things are getting shaky, baby. I thought I'd leave it all behind. Then things are getting better, baby.
We are joined by Irv Keister, the president-elect for NAIFA. And, you know, Irv, thank you for taking a minute to be with us here. You guys do a lot of community events. You do a lot for the area. You know, tell us a little bit about what it is that you do, because why would a Lehigh Valley resident want to, or how can they work with you and get the most out of the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors, which is what you guys are?
Yeah, well, Art, there's a lot of good reasons for Lehigh Valley residents to choose a National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisor as their representative. For me, one of the main reasons is the high ethical standards that NAIFA representatives are held up to. We work with clients and satisfy their needs by gathering facts, presenting those facts honestly and completely, and allowing clients to make informed decisions about their future.
And welcome to the first ever Lehigh County Hall of Fame induction ceremony here at the Great Agriplex of the Allentown Fairgrounds. Tonight, 24 individuals from 6 different fields, athletics, arts and entertainment, business, the military, innovation, and literature and communications will become the inaugural class of the Lehigh County Hall of Fame. The culminating ceremonies of the bicentennial community celebration that we've had throughout the day. The official bicentennial was on Tuesday. The biographies and photographs of this class of 24 people will be enshrined in plaques in a special Hall of Fame wing at the Lehigh Valley Heritage Center and Museum on Walnut Street in Allentown. The Heritage Center is a unique public facility that preserves and promotes the heritage and the history of the Lehigh Valley. We intend for there to be future classes, and discussions are already underway for a posthumous section in the Hall of Fame.